After successfully completing this lesson, you should understand the special circumstances that require a cofferdam to be filled and be familiar with the procedures involved in filling and circulating the cofferdam. To gain maximum benefit from this lesson, you should successfully have completed the previous lessons. This lesson discusses the special circumstances that require the cofferdam to be filled with liquid in order to prevent damage to the pump, including listing the cargoes involved. It then explains the techniques involved in filling and circulating the cofferdam. The practical sections consist of two parts. First, there is a demonstration of the procedures. This is followed by an interactive guided walkthrough of the same procedures. Due to their particular properties, some cargoes require special handling in order to avoid damage to the pump and lines. Standard operating procedure requires that the cofferdam is clean, dry, and vented to atmosphere through the exhaust trap vent line. This permits leakages to be easily detected. However, with certain cargoes, it is actually advantageous to fill the cofferdam with liquid. The working lifetime of the seals may be extended, and blockages of solidified cargo in the cofferdam can be avoided. The liquid used in the cofferdam varies depending on the cargo carried in the tank, as reaction between the two must also be considered. Normal purging routines will be suspended when the cofferdam is filled. The Framo purging report should be endorsed, indicating that the cofferdam has been filled and noting which liquid has been used. This lesson must be considered as general advice only, and specific company operating guidelines must always be followed. With the older open-loop systems, where there is no feed pump to maintain the pressure in the hydraulic circuit when the cargo system is not in use, there is a risk of contaminating the hydraulic oil when filling liquid into or circulating liquid around the cofferdam. In such systems, it is important that the hydraulic oil return pressure is always higher than the pressure in the liquid-filled cofferdam. The following cargoes require the cofferdam to be filled with liquid. Click the buttons to see more details. After discharging is completed and the pump cofferdam has been purged, it is recommended that fresh water is circulated through the cofferdam to remove any traces of acid. If they are allowed to remain and any moisture forms, such as from condensation, the mixture will become aggressive. Abrasive granules, such as from phosphoric acid, will also be washed away. A minimum of 5 to 10 litres of dioctylphenylate should be added to the cofferdam. This should be done prior to commencement of loading and remain until tank cleaning is almost completed. Without it, ingress of cargo is a slight possibility if the cargo seal was to fail, and should there be any moisture present, the product would then solidify and block the cofferdam. The DOP will ensure that any leakage remains in a liquid state. A blocked cofferdam is an extremely serious situation, which will lead to heat generation and a possible violent reaction. Indeed, a Framo deep well pump with a blocked cofferdam must not be run. As a minimal precaution, 5 to 10 litres of fresh water should be added to the cofferdam. This should be done prior to commencement of loading and remain until tank cleaning is well underway. If possible, it is even better to fill the cofferdam completely, rig a reservoir drum and small portable pump, and circulate the water during cargo discharge. The cofferdam should be filled with hot, fresh water and circulated during loading and discharge to prevent ingress and possible blockage from solidified product. Phenol has a melting point of approximately 45 degrees Celsius, so the heat is critical to this operation. The water may be heated by trickle feeding a live steam hose lashed into the drum or resting a small custom-built heating coil in the bottom. The cofferdam should be filled with hot, fresh water and circulated to prevent ingress and possible blockage from solidified product. Caustic soda 50% solution has a melting point of approximately 16 degrees Celsius, so the heat is important to this operation, especially in low ambient temperatures. The water may be heated by trickle feeding a live steam hose lashed into the drum or resting a small custom-built heating coil in the bottom. 5 to 10 litres of diesel oil or mineral spirit should be added to the cofferdam. This should be done prior to commencement of loading and remain until tank cleaning is almost completed. Once the cofferdam is emptied, it should be thoroughly cleaned and dried. Water, heated if necessary, can be circulated and air or nitrogen can be blown through to dry the cofferdam and associated piping. When filling the cofferdam, it is preferable to add the liquid by gravity. If a pump is used to transfer the liquid, it is essential to use low pressure, maximum 3 bar, in order not to damage the seals or exceed the hydraulic oil return pressure. Small traces of cargo residue may of course be expelled as the cofferdam is filled or recirculated. The appropriate personal protective equipment must always be used. This section deals with the addition of liquid to the cofferdam, either to partly or completely fill the cofferdam and its associated piping, and which then remains as a static preventative measure while the cargo or residues from the cargo are on board. You will now see a demonstration of the procedure to be followed when filling the cofferdam. Click on the buttons in numerical order. Disconnect the exhaust trap piping from the cargo pump top cover plate. Using a suitable adapter, fill the liquid through the cofferdam check pipe. Open the purging connection to ventilate the cofferdam during filling. This completes the demonstration of the procedure to be followed when filling the cofferdam. You will have noted in the previous section that the cofferdam was filled down the check pipe, with the displaced air being released up through the purge pipe. This is the easiest and most practical method to adopt when filling liquid that is going to remain as a static preventative barrier while a particular cargo is in the tank. In practice, however, the cofferdam can be filled from either direction. When the liquid is going to be continuously circulated around the cofferdam, an adapter must be fitted to the purging connection, and it then becomes easier to both fill and circulate in that direction, with the liquid returning out and back to the reservoir through the check pipe and exhaust trap connection. The aim is to add an auxiliary circuit consisting of a reservoir and circulating pump onto the cargo pump. The reservoir may be a purpose-built header tank or simply an open drum placed on deck adjacent to the top cover plate. The pump will typically be a small portable pump, commonly air-driven and capable of adjustment to regulate the flow. Small-bore flexible rubber hoses are usually employed to feed and return the liquid with the appropriate fittings and connections. Additional equipment, such as a steam supply or specially made heating coil, may also be added. You will now see a demonstration of the procedure to be followed when circulating liquid through the cofferdam. Click on the buttons in numerical order. Prepare the reservoir adjacent to the top cover plate. Fill with the required liquid. Add heating facility if necessary. Prepare and connect the circulating pump. Connect a flexible supply hose between the pump outlet and the purging connection. Connect another flexible hose from the exhaust trap drain valve and secure it so that it flows back into the reservoir. Slowly fill the cofferdam and associated piping, topping up the reservoir as required. Adjust pump regulator to achieve a slow, steady circulation. This completes the demonstration of the procedure to be followed when circulating liquid through the cofferdam.